Welcome to this short press briefing. First of all, I'd like to thank Prime Minister Ponta for coming to Copenhagen today and for an excellent meeting where we had a very good discussion. It's a pleasure to have you here, and we had the opportunity to have a good exchange. What we're seeing these days is that our two countries, Denmark and Romania, are becoming closer. We have always been close partners and allies, and our relation, our bilateral relation, is growing stronger these years. I'm glad to see that in terms of our trade relations, our relations between Denmark and Romania are only getting going from a good position to an even better position. And that's good for Romania, hopefully, and it's very good for Denmark as well. In fact, one of the things we agreed today was to improve our partnership by agreeing to explore Danish-Romanian cooperation in the field of green growth to see if that partnership can be enhanced by these agreements. We didn't only talk about our bilateral relation, we also talked about European issues, and we discussed the European situation. Of course, we touched upon the multilateral financial framework, and as you will know, one of the issues that is of interest to Romania, and of course the Romanian Prime Minister, is the issue of Schengen, where we have assured the Prime Minister, why I have assured the Prime Minister, that they can count on Denmark in keeping our position in terms of starting the Schengen procedure, of finalizing the Schengen admission. So this has been an excellent meeting. I thank you again, Prime Minister, for coming here today, and now the floor is yours.
Thank you very much. I would like to express my gratitude to Prime Minister Tony Schmidt for the invitation. As she already mentioned, our bilateral relationship has always been excellent, but good relations should be kept. And I'm very glad to be the first Prime Minister, Romanian Prime Minister, visiting Denmark after 2004. I would like to inform you, and as I informed the Prime Minister, that the most important issue of this visit was, of course, to confirm the political relationship, but also to try to have more economic relations. And Denmark for Romania, it's an excellent example of good governance, of green growth, of energy efficiency, and modern technologies in agriculture. So I just expressed to the Prime Minister, to the government, but also to the representatives of the business community in Denmark, that they are welcome in Romania. We have a huge potential, but also we have an important need for investments, for green investments, for new technologies in energy and agriculture. I'm very optimistic that Danish companies will invest more, and we will succeed together. What is our important and main goal as Prime Minister? To create jobs here in Denmark, in Romania, to create growth and to offer to our people a better future. I also like to appreciate very much the constant position of the Danish government in favor of Romanian's accession to the Schengen area, but also not only to Schengen area, but to play a more important role on the European stage. I invited the Prime Minister to come back to Bucharest and to spend more than several hours, like it happened last time, and of course to have the opportunity to see that Romania is not only Bucharest and the official buildings, and a green Romania should be an objective following the excellent example of green Denmark.
Thank you very much, Prime Minister. And now for some questions.
And
if there are any.
Okay, Mr. Prime Minister, I want to ask you, after your meeting with the businessman in the morning, what is your feeling about their, are they interested in Romania, to invest in Romania, and what are the fields, especially green investments or something else? And what companies are interested to invest in Romania? Thank you.
They definitely are interested, but as I expressed previously, the Danish business environment is used with a very transparent environment, with a very stable legislation. And the first thing that I assured them is that right now Romania is a stable and predictable country in terms of politics, but also in terms of legislation. We have our incentive strategies to convince the Danish companies to invest in energy and agriculture. And we have a particular interest in the energy efficiency. I would give you just one figure which is very important. Denmark and Romania are amongst the first three European countries in terms of energy independence, which is a great thing for both countries. But when it comes to the energy efficiency, Denmark is still on the first position and Romania is on the last one. So here it's the huge difference. And here we are very optimistic that the companies which, the CEOs of the companies which I met today, they will, some of them continue to invest in Romania, some others to open new investments.
Thank you. Any more questions?
If I said that to the domestic things, I'll answer to the airport. I think that it's going to be easier. Yeah. All right. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much. Yeah.